Sunday, when we read that passage from Acts 2, we remember the Spirit descending upon those early followers of Jesus. So we remember that history. But when we read it, we're not simply remembering history, we're joining history. There's a deep history at St. John's to gather here on Whit Sunday. So we're both acknowledging that history, and we're making history today as well. So we are now at a new Pentecost, a new time to gather and to think about how the Spirit might unfold upon us this year. I grew up in southeast Missouri, and as a kid, I had a stutter. I also had some difficulty, I think, with my P's and my S's. Any other fellow P and S trouble folks in the room? Anybody else? It was helpful that I believe that she was pretty. The speech therapist who came down the hall to take us to speech therapy room, I think it helped that she was pretty. Now, I don't know whose idea it was that said, you know, we should just leave the kids in the room and the speech therapist will walk down the hall and she'll get the kids with the stutters and the P and the S problems, and then they'll just kind of march together to speech therapy. That's really affirming for a first grader, right? You know? So who should we pick on at recess? I've got an idea. It really helped that she was pretty. And it really helped that once we got in that room with her, there was no more shame. We got in that room with her, and as well as I can remember, especially for those of us with stutters, it wasn't that we didn't have anything to say. It's almost like we had too much to say, and we couldn't get it out. She gave us some exercises. She gave us some tips. And over time, we learned to get the words out. And over time, I simply learned to avoid words with P and S's. That's right. I mean, it's pretty simple, right? True in their life, the desire to follow Jesus, to be baptized. therapist will help us get those words out. I hope this is not true, but at some point a few months ago, I read an article that said the average Episcopalian invites someone to church every 34 years. Did you see that article? I saw that article. So, we might be a church that needs a speech therapist. Because I believe there is a story of God in you. God has moved in your lives. It's simply a matter, can you get the words out? And realizing the story of God is too important simply to leave the bishops and the priests and the deacons. We're a part of that story with you. You have a story to tell. So my prayer today is that not only those being baptized and received and reaffirmed, but all of us will allow the Spirit to descend upon us and loosen our tongues and help us get the words out. The words of grace, the words of mercy, the words of joy, the words of forgiveness, words to inspire us and to renew us, and to let people know God's good news still moves in the land. And that all of us are commissioned to help tell that story. You'll also notice in the Gospel of John this morning, it's so important to remember that while today is the day of baptisms, confirmations, and receptions, today is just the beginning, or it's just a stop on an ongoing journey. I mean, one of the most powerful passages in the Gospel of John is when Jesus says to the disciples, there are many other things I'd like to say to you, but you cannot bear them. In January of 2020, you all remember January of 2020, remember that? Remember that? January of 2020, I had a chance to go to Rome, Italy. I went to Rome, never been to Rome before. Still haven't been to Rome, Georgia. Hope to do that someday. I had a chance to go to Rome, to walk in those streets, and at some point briefly met the Pope. I mean briefly met the Pope. He was on the move. But I left thinking 2020 is going to be the best year. Friends, the Christian life is lived in time, across time. We are now, pray God, on the other side of this pandemic, at least in this part of the world. There is much to celebrate. You are here in time and space. I have touched people and been touched by people today. We are giddy with excitement. But there are other things coming our way. And if we knew what those things were, we might not be able to bear them now. And they wouldn't just be bad things. There are also good things coming our way, but you might not think you have the strength to do them. You might not think you have the gifts to do them. You might not think you have the courage to do them. And so that is why the Spirit keeps showing up. Not just one Pentecost, but every Pentecost. Not just one Whit Sunday, but every Whit Sunday. And not just when we all gather, but also when you're alone in your room, and you are gripped by fear, and you're gripped by anxiety, the Spirit shows up and helps you to bear it one more time, and one more time, and one more time. It is a joy to be with you. As we prepare to baptize and confirm and receive, pray for that Spirit that will descend and loosen all of our tongues to proclaim good news.
by presenting these persons for confirmation to be received into this communion and to reaffirm their baptismal vows.
Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil?
I do.
Do you renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do. In God's grace, I will follow Him as my Savior and Lord.
And will all of you here who are witnessing to these vows and all of your power to support these persons in their life in Christ?
Amen.
As you are able, I would invite you to stand. And let us join those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our baptismal vows. Believe in God the Father.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
You believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God.
I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
In the breaking of bread and in the prayers.
I believe in God's help.
You persevere in resisting evil, and if you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord.
I believe in God's help.
You proclaim by word and example the good news of God and Christ.
I believe in God's help.
You seek to serve Christ in all persons, both your neighbor and yourself.
I believe in God's help. I will God's help.
Let us now pray for these persons who are to receive the sacrament of new birth, and for those who have renewed their commitment to Christ.
Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open their hearts to your grace and your truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Set them into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and joy.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of the Holy Spirit. May you come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to do.
Benjamin Richard Whittington.
Thank you.
confirmation. Defend, O Lord, as your companion with your heavenly grace, she may continue yours forever, daily increasing your Holy Spirit more and more, till she comes to your everlasting home.
Amen.
Mike Thomas, reaffirmation of baptismal vow. Reaffirmation of baptismal vows. For reaffirmation of baptismal vows.
Pete, may the Holy Spirit who has begun a good work in you direct and hold you in the service of Christ and his kingdom. Amen.
Lucy Grams for confirmation. Sarah Grams for reception.
Sarah, we recognize you as a member of one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We receive you into the fellowship of this community. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Martha Georgeson, reaffirmation of baptism. Confirmation. Nancy Margeson, confirmation. Ben Whittington for confirmation.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Ben, with your heavenly
I love each of you, and I give thanks to God